Hello students, hope you are doing great. CS Executive December attempt. You have to do Finance Act 16 for this December attempt. And students, those who are appearing for June attempt next year will be doing Finance Act 17. For December attempt, there are hardly 5 months left. By end of October, the entire syllabus must be through and entire November and December should be given and should be devoted only towards revision. In this voice record, I'll be sharing golden rules to crack a tax paper. Rather, these rules are such efficient rules which will not only help you to crack a tax paper, but if you follow these rules, definitely for your lifetime, you will never forget what tax is. First rule is to step into the shoe of a lawmaker. When you are doing your tax paper, whenever you are reading the sections, whenever you are reading the concepts behind the tax in the syllabus, you should understand that the act has been issued by the parliament, the government. You should understand this is a message from the government. So you should keep yourself into the shoe of a lawmaker. You should feel yourself as a government of India and understand why the government had given such kind of a section. Somewhere, sections and the concepts have been made to charge more and more tax from the richer people and less from the poor to maintain the equality, since we are a mixed economy. No one person can be rich and getting even richer, and poor are getting poor. Another thing, wherever the government feels the tax is being evaded, the special sections are issued that time. They insert new sections through Finance Act. So these are examples where you should understand and you should keep into the shoe of a lawmaker to understand why such a section or why such a concept must have been brought into the act. Second, practice. When you are doing your numericals, when you are doing MCQs, you have to practice it not only just once. If you practice once, I am very sure you will forget it tomorrow. But to retain it till October end, rather till December end, or maybe forever, because this entire tax which you are doing at present in your executive level will come back in finance and for only 30 mark. So that time this is going to be a real burden if you don't do it very nicely at present in this very attempt. The entire thing, the entire topic will come back again in your advanced tax laws in your final paper, and the content is the same. So it is very important for you to do it now, and do it not only till December for your December attempt, do it for your final attempt. Explore and relate to practical life. Whenever you are doing your sections, it is very important for you to explore. Only if you are in a live class, and it is never that true that life classes are the best classes. I believe self-study, exploring the sections for yourself. Keep 1 hour of your day free for the news. Turn on the TV news for 1 hour. Try to relate to practical life. Go look for the topics and the discussions where you think something on tax is being discussed. And if you have read it, you should definitely listen to it. For an example, the section 28 of PGBP, what includes income under the head business and profession. Section 28 is a little difficult for students to retain, but very important section. It defines the income types of income which is taxed under the head PGBP section 28, the charging section of PGBP. Once you go through the section you've been taught in the class, the section line by line, you should go back, sit you on your phone itself, just Google section 28. You will find examples. There will be discussions over the topic. Definitely, this will help you to retain it for a very long time. Only lectures and teachers will not help you to retain anything. Revise and revise. Practice. Once you do your sections, numericals, practices for 1, 2, 3, at least 4 to 5 number of times, and revision. These two are the very important golden rule to crack the tax paper. Entire November and December, since I have said, you should be kept aside for only revision. By end of October, the entire syllabus must have been completed. Also, this revision which I am trying to highlight in the fourth point is the revision which has to be done simultaneously. Once your chapter 1 is finished and you jump to chapter 2, chapter 1 has to be revised simultaneously. You have to do everything new daily, and the revision of previous chapters and topics which is done already has to be done thoroughly and very nicely. You should keep 15 to 20 minutes of the day spare for only revision. The chapter, something like PGPP. If you miss a class, okay, fine. You can get the connectivity because every section is different. But it is such a lengthy chapter that if you don't revise it today, during the time you are actually doing it for the first time, trust me, you will never be able to solve questions by end of the attempt, by October, November, December. This will create only stress and panic during your exam. The chapter like capital gain. Capital gain chapter, you should never miss a class. Every chapter, every section of the capital gain chapter is so interconnected that once you miss a section, it is very difficult for you to understand the entire chapter. Very critical chapter, but very interesting chapter. I'm telling you, the fifth rule also said the same. Be very confident. Tax is not difficult. Only the problem which students feel is the understanding the language of the tax. What is the tax maker trying to say? Tax is a paper about facts. It is a fact. It is what you have to do and what you don't have to do is written in this simple language. And if you earn this much, pay tax this much by this date and in this form. If you spend this much, it is allowed or not allowed. Such practical things are given. So, tax paper is not at all difficult, provided you revise it daily. You give 10 to 15 minutes daily for the paper. It is not difficult, only the language is difficult. If you remember these 5 rules, trust me, and you follow it thoroughly, nobody can defeat you, nobody can prevent you from cracking the tax paper. Every line you read should be filtered in such a way that you are able to form MCQ from each line. This paper being an MCQ based, once the question goes wrong and you get a negative marking, there is no descriptive question. You will never get a long question like you used to get it before. It is one liner MCQ. They are trying to judge the concepts, the basic concepts from you all. There is not going to be any lengthy numerical. All the best. Keep subscribed yourself into this channel. And there'll be more and more videos coming for other papers as well. And hit that bell button if you are not a regular user on YouTube, so that you keep getting messages and notifications once the videos are uploaded. Thank you so much and all the best.